Okay, hi guys, and welcome to another Showcase Sunday. I hope you are all in good health and positive spirit always. If we are meeting for the first time, my name is Kairi Johari, better known as Pak JoFe, the Chris Collector from Singapore, and you are watching the Chris Collector Show, Showcase Sunday. In today's video, I am sharing one of my many personal favorites. Today, I am sharing a weapon class from the southern cluster of islands of today's Philippines. Prior to colonial occupation by the Spanish and the Americans, southern Philippines comprised of several ethnic races whom identified themselves as the Bangsa Moro, or the Moros, who were predominantly Muslim and ruled by three Islamic sultanates: the Raja Buayan, the Sultanate of Maguindanao, and the Sultanate of Sulu. Now, I am not an expert on every customs and traditions of the diverse ethnic cultures that makes up the people of the Philippines today. If there are any inaccuracies in any facts presented, please correct me by the comment section. This example was added to my collection sometime back in 2012. At the time of this acquisition, I was told by the dealer that this was somewhat a vintage piece made sometime back 20 to 25 years earlier, comprising of German silver fittings and a hilt carved from buffalo horn. Now, German silver is not silver, it is an alloy comprising of copper, nickel and zinc. There is no real silver in it despite being called German silver. In some places, it is also referred to as alpaca silver. Overall, in my view, craftsmanship is aesthetically pleasing. Now, in the Philippines, this weapon type is known by several names depending on which ethnic tribe you ask. The Mindanaos and Visayas refer to this as a gunungan knife. The Tagalogs call them bunong. The Spaniard colonizers call them the punyal de Chris. The Yakans call it the badao. And the Lumat calls it the balarao. Many names, but it is in essence the same weapon. Supposedly, this weapon type has been in existence predating colonial rule. Just like the Chris, the gunung is part of the daily dress attire and utilitarian tool, both for the purpose of completing daily tasks and as a weapon for self-defense as a last resort. Typically worn attached to the waistcloth via the belt clip-like hook designed onto the scabbard and positioned behind one's back for concealment and quick draw. The Richikan details of this knife is reminiscent of the Chris blade. It features a blade with locks, and there are examples that features a straight blade as well, just like those on a traditional Chris. Historically, the Moros descended from pioneer sailors from the Malay lands who sailed the seas and decided to call the southern islands of Sulu their new home. Perhaps some semblance of beliefs was adapted to this weapon that may have evolved out of necessity to match native combat fighting styles and techniques. Unlike the Chris, however, the gunungan knife is both a thrusting and slashing weapon type. Given its broad design, ease of handling, and protective guard at its base to protect the hands of those wielding this weapon, to a trained hand, this weapon type definitely can inflict serious bodily injuries. The subject of weapon types from the Philippines itself is quite broad and definitely a lot more grounds to cover. It is, however, interesting to note that amongst the many weapon types of the Philippines, the Chris holds a significant position within the Moro community. Perhaps I will do a more in-depth coverage on this in a future video. That is all for today's showcase. Thank you for watching till the end. I hope this video adds value to you and may you learn something new and useful from watching this. I look forward to reading your feedback in the comments section, so please feel free to leave me your comments and I will personally reply to you. If you like what you have watched today, please share with me your support by clicking the like, subscribe, and bell notification icon. So, until we meet in my next video, this is Kairi Johari, better known as Pak JoFe, the Chris Collector from Singapore, snapping out. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.